world Joseph today.
Well, in all honesty, barrel for barrel, my wife wanted me to.
Oh, so you didn't volunteer on your own, somebody else volunteered for you?
Oh, no.
Say it ain't so, Joe. Say it ain't so.
Oh, I can't. I wish I could, but my wife says I'm kind of a caveman. Stuck in my own little world, watching way too much sports, and since I care way too much about, NASCAR, you really then I do about giving back to the body of Christ.
Okay, well, I see. Well,
can you believe that?
Yeah, Joseph is, it's a big role, you know, the earthly father of Messiah, trekked a trail from his hometown all the way to Bethlehem, on foot, over 300 miles. And he did all that to register for the census. Yeah. He's married to a woman that was pregnant with the Son of God. Big shoes to fill, Joe.
Oh, yeah. I should have probably auditioned for the shepherd because, well, all they do is watch sheep and keep to themselves. Again, it was my wife's idea because, well, my full name is Joseph Arlene Stillman.
Yeah. Arlene?
Yeah. My mama was a twin, and her sister's name was Arlene, and I was a third child of the family. Hence why I got my aunt's name as my middle name, Arlene. Oh, embarrassing, humiliating. Makes you just want to run and hide when your mom calls out your full name. Joseph Arlene Stillman! You better put that cat down, boy! God did not put him on his earth and make a boomerang out of it. Mama, she was always very sensitive.
Yeah, well, I guess someone needed to. You know, you might just be perfect for the role of Joseph, Joe.
Oh, pound for pound, I am just not seeing what you're seeing, I reckon.
Well, here's the deal. All the emotions that you've felt and that you're feeling right now, mm-hmm. the confusion, the embarrassment, yeah. the humiliation, mm-hmm. disillusionment, yep. well, Joseph felt all of those.
What? I've seen the live nativity and there isn't any of those emotions in that manger, see? He always looks so happy looking at baby Jesus.
Well, that's true. Mm-hmm. How do you think Joseph got to that moment, looking and feeling so happy, though? Mm-hmm. You know, what do you think the emotions were going on in his head and his heart when the angel delivered the news that Mary would be carrying the Son of God?
Mm. Wow, I never thought of it like that. I pretty much picture him saying, okay, be good with it, you know?
Right, as you would say, pound for pound.
Oh, there you go ahead and say
it. It was probably a major blow to his world.
Yep.
He had to decide whether to follow what the angel Gabriel told him, as crazy as it sounded, or do what was best for himself.
Wow. That's pretty much how I live my life, I guess. I'm more a live and let live kind of guy, if you know what I mean.
A lot of people are. It's easier to be that way. But think about what it says in Luke 1:19. The angel Gabriel told Joseph, I stand in the presence of God, and I was sent to speak to you and to bring you this good news. Mm-hmm. Do you think it was good news at first for Joseph? Mm-hmm. I mean, or did you think maybe he had to wrestle with what everyone would think?
I kind of guess it wasn't really his will be done, but God's will.
Exactly.
I go ahead and say it. Yeah. It's kind of like my situation. Not really my will, but my wife.
Oh, Lord. Now you're getting off track. Okay. Speaking of a union, Joseph, after hearing the news and being a righteous man, wanted to divorce Mary quietly so it wouldn't be brought to the public. Well, back then, even during an engagement, which they weren't officially married yet, they were betrothed, engaged, it still took quite a bit to get the two separated, to get a legal divorce. Well, he thought Mary was unfaithful. It wasn't until the angel told Mary to take her home that Joseph followed and listened, paid attention.
Well, I figured if Joseph felt and wondered all those things, maybe I am right for this role. Ooh, he slapped your mama. Go ahead, put me in, coach. I'm ready to play. Come on. I'll be the best Joseph you've ever seen.
That's right. Well, I think you nailed your audition with the simple realization, not your will, but God's will be done. His son would say the same exact thing 30 years later in the Garden of Gethsemane.
Yep. I'll remember that when I'm looking down at baby Jesus. I guess that's what you theater folk call being the character.
Come on.
Before we get started, do I got weirdo biblical roll thingamajiggers, you know, with the little man right there going
ahead. Yeah, bro, you do.
Oh, can we just try something different? I got my new camo underpants. And they're kind of like a robe. We got the little brown right there. Go ahead.
All
right,
sorry. Not your will.
Oh, come on.
What? You get it?
Yeah, I get it, Pastor.
Joe?
Yes.
Give me that Joseph pose one more time.
Oh, you ain't ready for this one, right? Hey, I've been practicing for weeks.
You might need to work on that. It looks like you're ready to pounce. All right, Joseph, you got the role. Thank you so much.
All right, thank you.